You might not realize it, but you could be doing some things that may destroy your life without even realizing it. Yes, maybe it started as a mistake initially, but turning them into everyday practice can affect you negatively in more ways than you can imagine. I'm pretty sure the last thing you want to do is spend your old age wishing you never did some things or that you did some others. I mean, it'll probably not make any point or sense to do so at a time like that. To avoid ending your life with lots of regrets, it is vital to build good habits and let go of the bad. You're wondering how you can achieve that, right? First of all, you have to identify the bad habits that you want to stop and then substitute them with good habits. In this video, I'll share with you 13 things we do to destroy our lives. If you're new here, consider subscribing so that you don't miss out on exciting videos like this. 1. Blaming others and making excuses. No matter what or who is responsible for the situation you find yourself in life, you'd never be able to leave the hurt behind you and become successful if you keep blaming them or making excuses. What you should do is forget about the past and take the responsibility of your life in your hands. Unless you take steps to move on, no one will help you. A famous Stephen Covey's quote goes like this: "Until a person can say sincerely and honestly, I am what I am today because of the choices I made yesterday, that person cannot say I choose otherwise." You see, blame and excuse making are similar creatures. Blame is playing offense and excuses are on defense. Both are avoiding accountability. So, whether or not a person or thing is responsible for your present situation, they are not responsible for your life. Until you realize this, you might never be able to achieve anything significant in life. 2. Making your health low priority. Many times, people do not pay attention to their health until they come to the end of their lives. Research has shown that how you treat your body today will determine the type of shape you'll be in your 50s. So, if you want to enjoy the best of your life, especially when you are old, it will help to start paying attention to your health now. The truth is that we take a lot of years to work and make money, but we only get one chance to take care of our health today. Jim Rohn once said, "Take care of your body, it's the only place you have to leave." So, learn to schedule your appointments and meetings appropriately and also ensure that you have enough time to sleep or rest. 3. Living in fear. Yes, the world is full of uncertainties and no one can determine what tomorrow holds. But that isn't enough reason to live in fear. How about enjoying today to the fullest? How about enjoying every beat of the day, doing the things that you love most? I mean, living in fear wouldn't solve any problem after all. So, once again, you have yet another reason to live life to the fullest. Stop focusing on what you don't have. Let go of the fear of how badly things could go. We all have a limited number of days in this life. Don't waste one more moment. Instead, be grateful. Practice gratitude for everything that you have. 4. Worrying about what other people think. Too often, we concern ourselves with what other people think about us, the things we do, or even how we look, when in the real sense, only a few people pay attention. Olin Miller, a famous author, said, "You probably wouldn't worry about what people think of you if you could know how seldom they do." Well, it's high time you stopped comparing yourself to others. You need to focus on yourself. Do what's best for you, not what people think is best for you, not what you think people will consider best. It's about you and what makes you happy, not them. 5. Waiting for perfect time. Sometimes, waiting for perfect time is an excuse we use to make to mask our fears. There's no ideal time than now. If you want to get something done, start now. It doesn't matter whether you think the timing is perfect or not. If you make mistakes, you'll learn. You'll never be ready. You'll never have it all figured out. And as you step into what you feel called to do, it will change and take on a life of its own. So, put a date to it. Step into your fears and start now. 6. Spending your money to impress people. One of the reasons we find ourselves living paycheck to paycheck is because we spend our money buying things that we don't need just to impress others. The implication of doing this is that you end up wasting your money because you are trying to prove a point to people. Imagine if you put that extra money into a retirement account, allowing compound interest to work in your favor. By the time you are ready to retire, your capital must have accrued a substantial interest. 7. Settling for less. We get it. Life can be pretty challenging. All of us will go through the hard or tough part of life whether we like it or not. But settling for less than we desire or even deserve will never make you happy. It's like you'll be living below your potential, which will make your life miserable in the end. Even if everyone around you is saying otherwise or convincing you to do so, you need to determine not to. Most times, people try to transfer their fears to others by advising them to settle for the safest choice, which in most cases is less. 8. Postponing stuff for the future. Rick Pitino, an American professional basketball coach, said, "Postponing action is only postponing achievement. When you postpone what you should do today, you're pushing forward the achievement of today. The problem is that you won't be happy at the end of the day knowing that you still have work to do. So, instead of enjoying the moment, you are spending it worried about your work." Abraham Lincoln said, "You cannot escape the responsibility of tomorrow by evading it today." So, why not do what you have to do today instead of postponing it? 9. Wishing you get the things that you want instead of planning. If wishes were a bed of roses, does this ring a bell? Well, if anyone could achieve anything they wanted by merely wishing it, the world would probably not be a safe place to be, because every one of us would have spent it wishing all kinds of things. To achieve your goal in life, you have to make plans and take actions. Wishes alone won't get you there. 10. Trying to do everything all by yourself. No man is an island, and you're most definitely not one, so you can't possibly do everything all by yourself. Quit trying to do that. No man has ever created something big in his life without using the knowledge and resources that other people had before him. Stop isolating from the rest of the world in hopes that it will help you succeed. It won't. If you genuinely want to be successful, you need to ask for help, find like-minded people, and surround yourself with them. 11. Taking things personally. Your opinion about yourself should matter more to you than any other. Sometimes, people say mean things to us that they don't mean. So, why do they do it? Well, they are unconsciously projecting their fears to you. So, why worry about them when their opinion about you don't count at the end of the day? Don Miguel Ruiz, a Mexican author, said, "But it is not what I am saying that is hurting you. It is that you have wounds that I touch by what I have said. You are hurting yourself. There is no way I can take this personally." 12. Saying yes to everything. One of the hardest things for most people is learning to say no. That you want to be empathetic doesn't mean you should try to please everyone because you can't keep up. So, ask yourself what makes you happy. Create more of those opportunities and say yes to them more often to them. But do not go out of your way to please others. 13. Not learning or improving your life. Finally, no matter what we do or who we become in life, if we stop learning or self-developing, we'll begin to lose our relevance. So if you want to remain valuable, don't stop learning. Thank you very much for watching our videos. If you like this video, watch more videos on our channel and subscribe. We love you.